In this video, we'll talk about the different types of forums that you can build in the course. Here's the six types, one example for each. The first one is the announcements forum. So this is a unique forum designed to send messages to the students, but not in an engaging way. We can't have them reply back to this forum. So here in the announcements forum, you can see that I've posted two pieces here, no class on Monday, exam on Friday. This is designed to be a one-way communication. These are announcements out to the class. Another important function to think about with this is these will not go out to students if the course is hidden. You have to turn the course on to see these. So I've posted these. My added discussion is the same as the other ones. If I go back to my home page for sample course and I open the blocks drawer, those are the things that show up under latest news. So no class on Monday, exam on Friday were the postings that I made in the announcements. If I go into this as a student, here I am as a student view. If I go into announcements, I can read these, but notice there is no add to discussion. And if I read this, there is no reply link. So this really is a one-way discussion out to student, or one-way announcement out to students. It is not a true discussion. As a student, if I open the block drawer and I have latest announcements, I will also see that I have the teacher in this class has posted these. So that's a good way to send announcements out. But be aware, if the course is hidden, those do not go out as emails to the students. The course has to be available. As a teacher, the standard forum for general use is the next forum type. And here I can add as many discussions as I'd like. So here I've added a discussion. Additionally, a student has added a discussion. If we go into the discussion, you will see here where students have replied back both to the original discussion and to each other. And if we look at postings that they've done, so this is a posting the student does, I can reply back to that posting and other students can reply. So this is a good way to get a large general forum postings. Forum discussions. Herein, as a student, if we go and look at the forum for general use, so here's the posting that the instructor made. Here is posting I made as a student. I can add this, that. I can also come in here and reply to any of the discussions or reply to a reply from other discussions. Here as a teacher, we'll look at single simple discussion. So this is the idea that there are no sub forums. It's all within here. And this first posting comes from inside the settings, what I've put in the description. So the description will be the first kind of posting, and then students will be able to reply to that. Here's a student. I'm going to go into single simple discussion. And you can see here, I have no place to put a new discussion. All I can do is reply to any of these. So I can go here and write a reply to another student or to the instructor's original prompt. As a faculty member, I can come in here, and the next forum type is each person post one discussion. And so I can come in and start posting here. I've posted this first topic, a student has posted, and I can go in and edit and reply to those. As a student, I can go into each person post one discussion, and this particular student has already posted a discussion, so here is their topic that they posted. They can now read any postings and reply to them, but there is no started discussion topic. In as a different student that has not posted a discussion, I'm going to go into each person just post one discussion. And now I see this add discussion topic here. So if I click on this, I will get my own discussion thread. And I can still eventually, you know, go in and reply to other threads, but this is my way of making my one shot at that. As a faculty member, if I go down to the Q&A forum, I can come in here and post a discussion. So this is the discussion that I've posted. I've got a student that has replied to this. So if I go in as that student, I'm looking at the Q&A forum as a student that's already made a reply or answered a question. So here, if I click on this, here's the reply this student made, and they can now see other replies for students within the class. Logged in as a student that has not made a reply to the class yet, I'm going to go into Q&A forum and click on the Q&A, and so all they can see is the instructor's original prompt. They can reply to that, but they can't see any of the other prompts that the students have made. So that's the big difference, is once I make a reply, I have 15 minutes for it to process through, and then I will be able to see other students' replies. In as a faculty member, here is standard forum displayed as a blog-like format. So really, this is very similar to the standard form for general use. It'll just change the way that these are displayed. So here it is. Instead of just seeing everything nested down, all the replies, you have to go into discuss this topic. So if I go into this, I will see the threading underneath of it, but it gives me kind of a blog or a summary view at the beginning of it of all the discussions formed here. Other than that, it's just like the standard forum.